Hi everyone, today I wanted to talk about setting yourself up for success in investing by building a great team of professionals around you. A successful investor often appears to just buy a property, find a tenant, and wait for the money to come in, but this is very rarely the case. Most successful investors actually have a great team of professionals assisting and advising them before, during, and after the purchasing process. Some learn this lesson the hard way after they've been investing for a few years and run into some avoidable issues. The earlier you can establish your network of valuable professionals, the earlier you can reap the rewards, capitalizing on their experience. Having experienced professionals on your team means that when issues arise, you're able to get solid specialist advice, which helps to make those issues a lot less stressful for you and can help to keep you on track to achieving your goals. I've broken down my list of essential players into three key groups: the planning group, the purchasing group, and the maintenance group. The planning group helps you avoid mistakes and flag issues that those with experience would know to avoid. Some professionals in this group are accountants, mortgage brokers and lenders, buyer's agents, and property managers. The great thing about the professionals in the planning group is they help you avoid making the wrong purchase before you're overly committed. Another added benefit is that by following their advice, you can invest your time wisely. For example, on properties inside your budget, or by making sure that you're looking for properties that can attract the types of tenants and the return that align with your investing goals. For these reasons, I strongly recommend having your planning group fully established before putting any offers in on potential investment properties. You can discuss and plan your investment strategy with your accountant or your financial planner. They can let you know whether it's realistic, and they can often help in building a plan that will work towards your money-based goals. Speaking to a broker or a lender can help you to establish your borrowing capacity and tell you what your repayments will look like, so that you can accurately budget for your purchase and any ongoing expenses. A buyer's agent and a property manager will be able to provide reports that outline market trends and advice on what makes an attractive rental to potential tenants, giving you a competitive edge when it comes to negotiations. I would also recommend having your property manager view the property to ensure you're not purchasing someone else's nightmare. Once you've found a property that aligns with your goals and you have negotiated a price that you are happy to commit to, the next step is to engage your purchasing group to ensure that your agreement and your purchase are both what they seem. In your purchasing group, you have your building and pest inspectors, a conveyancer, and an insurance broker. Your building and pest inspector will be able to advise whether the property is in good condition or for its age and flag any issues. Great inspectors should not only tell you if a property has any defects, but they should also walk you through what the issues actually mean in language that you understand, and give advice on who you should engage to fix these issues. Your insurance broker, of course, can make sure you and your property are covered if something terrible happens. Your conveyancer will be able to check your contract so they can ensure your agreement is both compliant and fair. And conveyancers often know more about sales contract than sales agents do. So regardless of whether you're buying or selling a property, they're an awesome resource. Once your purchase has settled, your planning group and your purchasing group sit on the team bench until you're looking to buy another property. The one exception to this is, of course, your property manager. Your maintenance group are the long-term players in your team that don't get a break. Great tradespeople will be cost-effective, will do quality work, and will also be great communicators with your tenants, which is why having this part of your team established is so important. The key professionals to have on your maintenance team are a handyman, a plumber, an electrician, a painter, a gardener, and a cleaner. If you are interviewing a property manager to see if the agency is a good fit, you should ask lots of questions about their tradespeople. How they interact with their tradespeople, how their tradespeople interact with your tenants, how work is assigned to the tradespeople, and how quotes are handled. Often your property manager will be the bottleneck in your maintenance plan. How they communicate with your team is crucial. The three big advantages of getting this mix right are: your property will last longer with quality workmanship, your balance sheet will look better with competitive pricing, and your tenants will be happier because they have tradespeople that treat them like they're a priority. If you're ready to build your team for the first time or have noticed some gaps in your contacts, here are some actionable steps for finding great professionals. Start by asking friends if they know any professionals that they can recommend, and ask them why they would recommend these particular people. If you already have people on your team, ask them who they would use or recommend and why. And finally, use tools like Google Reviews as a starting point to give you an idea of who you should be shortlisting and who you should avoid. Not every team is going to be the same, but you're more likely to succeed in all things in life if you have the right people and the right resources there to assist you. If you'd like to talk to myself or a member of our team about some recommendations for professionals that we use, please give us a call or send through your details for us to arrange a callback.